Howdy doodly. I'm fed and watered, so I'm going to play some more of Lost Odyssey. As we left off, I am running around in Ura, looking for things to do, things to find. So, we will pick up here. I don't want to run directly into the back alleys. But I've got this square to go to give the old guy the letter and a few other areas. It's the big house right over there. Physics! Throw physics to the dog, I'll none of it. Nice. I could have sworn that old man's supposed to be here. Oh, okay. I'm guessing there's enemies in here? Ah, one of these for Tolton, though. Let me guess. There's a trial down here. experiment should be in here.
Yikes!
He was an experiment. Probably should have done a magic attack with him. Gotta be careful, because obviously they can inflict petrification. Oh, fuck yeah, Kaim. So I have started putting Christ parts 24 up to, well, I've activated 3 or 4 parts. On my YouTubes. But they go up to about 50. So I've got some more. I'll set them all up. I'm going to set them off so they'll go. It's going to end up being at least 3 or 4 videos, maybe a day. For the next week, easily. Do you know, I actually think it's better for me, whilst I'm now pissing around exploring, if I actually put Sed on and get everybody to have the increase AP skill. Double SP rather. And I just literally start getting that with everybody. That will make my life a little bit easier. Nice. That'll help rebuild some of the coffers, because I went on a minor bender buying some items, mostly for making ring assembly.
We've taken the advantage.
And he's now got the 64 gun. Thank you. bit of an improvement. Yeah, whilst their grid's still up. Ooh, nice! Dizziness. Oh, it's Dizzy Wasco, isn't it?
Phew. That was a close one.
Mother Nature's spirit. Ooh, finally got some. Ultimate analysis. Let me guess, that does all three at once. Yep. So what that means, actually, I'm going to take those off. I shall give him gonna give him those. I will give Seth reduce casting because she's quite handy with spirit magic. Chris HP back to MP. Yep. Right. I'm being stupid. New things, yep. Oh god, yeah, I picked up loads of shit, didn't I? I should put petrification immunization on, but I'm guessing we're going to turn a couple more if we go through that doorway.
Not too smart, eh?
that son of a bitch get a counterattack? Does Ming get she should do. Cause it goes off for the
It's not in my nature to lose.
Okay, or do they? If they're petrified, do they not learn anything? Which is how most games do it. I never really paid attention to that, I will be 100% honest. No, she didn't. Okay, yep, that's, I'd never paid attention to that in this, but that makes total sense, because that's how most other RPGs are. Don't know where I'm going. I'm on a route to nowhere. Magical lock key. Magical dreamland. Ha ha!
Scared too.
Oh, very clever. Funny. Yeah. What is your problem? What are you hiding behind your mama?
Wait, what did you just say?
Okay, okay. We go against each other, we play right into Gongora's hands.
It looks like something's happening. Be on guard.
Kinda wish I'd gone through that other doorway now and see if there's anything there.
Let your guard down, eh?
They're sexy and creepy. I don't like it. Yeah. Backyard Weekly. Okay. Nope. Secret Cave. Alright, well, what does that do? Right, that must be what the guy will ask for help. For the other ones, then.
Sent on a mission. I'm not from this world. However, I've been sent to investigate this world. I have teleported across time and space. My consciousness continued even after I took on a physical form, and remains to this day. My home world and this world, for some reason, the two worlds seem to be linked on the same axis across space and time. Our world is becoming extremely unstable. Reports have begun to circulate that it would collapse. We believe this to be caused by interference from another world. This world, that was on the same axis as ours. Our pure and tarnished world was being warped and distorted by some unknown force. Not unlike a virus distorting a living being. Over the course of time, we realized that this virus could well be a soul or spirit. The interference from that other world was from the souls of its inhabitants. They were producing some form of energy that was distorting our world. Why did it have such an influence? To understand the cause of this phenomenon, to study this interference, we established a quantum teleporter, a means to send our consciousness to this other world. And so we came to investigate. Including myself, there are 5 investigators. The others are Kaim Arganar, Seth Balmar, Ming Namara, and Sarah Sissonart. We arrived here without memories of our home world, and now live among the native inhabitants of this world. While we carry out our mission, 1,000 years was chosen as a time frame sufficient to develop a deep understanding of this world's inhabitants. The way we arrived, with our memories locked away, has allowed us to become like the people we now live among. However, I awoke to the memory of this mission some days ago. I am leaving this recording so that this world may know that I existed. Given that time flows differently on the two worlds, we shall appear to neither age nor die on this world. The 1,000 years of our investigation is equivalent to the passing of only a single year on our home world. With the difference in the flow of time, we live much longer lives than those around us. By immersing ourselves in the history, culture, thoughts, and habits of this world, we succeeded in gathering detailed data. We will transmit our experiences to our home world in the hopes that it will give us the means of saving it. An unexpected result of our mission is that the Tower of Mirrors is causing a variety of odd changes in the natural order of this world. Wild animals run amok, and there are many sightings of monstrous creatures. The natural magic energy of this world has changed. This may in fact be a blessing. Magic energy has dramatically improved the lives of these people. When our consciousness was reconstituted within our new bodies, there was a resonance with the magic energy. The possibility that our existence has imparted even greater strength to this world's magic energy is very likely. We have seen much in our 1,000 years here, which brings us to the true nature of the virus. The lives and history of the people here are extremely ordinary, and we have seen many dynasties rise to power and fall again into oblivion, as if they were nothing but trivial occurrences. And yet the existence of the virus on our world shows that the events of this world had a tremendous impact, making a history that will never be recorded in any book here. Their feelings that dominate the minds of the people of this world, their hopes and desires, their love and their hatred, their very lives and deaths, the events that bring fear or happiness to their every moment, all of these resulted in massive waves of something that interfered with our own world. The hearts and minds of the people is what moves this world. At certain times, this was evident by the feelings of affection toward others. At other times, it was shown by the unrestrained drive to satisfy a great ambition. In the time we have lived among the people of this world, we have realized that these feelings previously unknown to us profoundly affect them. And the effects of these feelings are causing the massive energy waves that are affecting our homeworld. From our standpoint, these feelings are simply a virus. But in the course of 1,000 years, we have found them to be a very seductive virus. While here in this world, I have been infected by the virus of feeling and have consequently attained powerful magic energy. To abandon this would be grievous and painful. To even think this way shows how deeply the virus has infected me. But the virus's seduction has been quite satisfying, and it still is.
Ah. Demon King's Horn and Demon King Ring. That looks like a Jansen weapon. So basically, the emotions of this world are affecting our world. Interesting. Okay. That's where it leads to. Where do you lead? Is that the one up to his top room?
Eternity. It's amazing to not have fear of death as long as I am in this world. I am immortal, akin to a god. I am this world's time and history in one person. However, to remain so, I must destroy the Tower of Mirrors. But if I do, it will break the link to the power of my home world, and I will lose the magic energy of this world. If that happens, my immortality will be swept along in the flow of time. I need to create a magic energy engine in this world to replace the Tower of Mirrors. An engine would stamp out the interference from my whole world and give me access to even more magic energy here. First, I must establish a power base to ensure that this world runs according to my will, the Royal House of Ura. I can position myself into that house to gain power and manipulate the people with that power and the magic energy. My place
Yeah, I had a feeling it was that. Hello. Aha. I guess they're just to find the item that he mentioned.
I'm always ready.
Nice. Although Tolton removed the royal seal, obviously the treasure's been plundered by Gongora, most likely. I'm also aware of, I'm just looping around in a circle here, but I am aware that I didn't quite need to do that. I'm just wanting to double check. I am satisfied. Let me out. There's nothing else really to do here in Gongora's mansion. We've caught those story elements. I'll just double check there's nothing else up here. Like those. And this. Right, I think it's safe to say that we've done everything in Gongora's mansion. So we found the hidden item, we've had a couple of explanations. Yeah, I mean, it makes sense. He's awoken to his memories. Why he did or how he did, but I suppose it ultimately doesn't matter in so much as the fact is that he just did. And I believe I've kind of said that mildly, is that he's wanting to stay here, and because of what makes them them, he's trying to figure out by an Uren soldier solid seed. I'll need to find where the hell the peapot is again. I do not remember. It's down the alleyway, isn't it? Alright, we're gonna save though. And for the YouTubers, we'll be back in a moment. So see you then.